might not be any of my business, but JC's crew's headed this way to bump you. And they all got shanks.
You good looking at him?
Be good, homie.
This motherfucker right here, this motherfucker think he's special. Wanna be left alone and shit. Don't wanna be mobbed up with the rest of us niggas. Like we ain't shit. You understand what I'm saying? Shit don't work like that around here, my boy. Back. Kinda tight too. This shit don't mean nothing around here though, player. I done seen a whole lot of built motherfuckers getting their ass bent over from here every day. Understand what I'm telling you? I'm talking to you, partner.
You got to the count of five.
This motherfucker talking to me.
What?
You hear this motherfucker?
Two.
You hear this motherfucker?
Three.
Just signed your own death certificate, player. Shit!
I need you to deliver a message. I want you to tell every motherfucker behind these walls that if they get the notion to fuck with me, don't.
Before I call the police on your asses again.
Fuck you, you old Brad Sanford looking ass.
Take your ass back to TV land, you Nick at Night looking motherfucker. Please, homie.
Taking three moves ahead. Woo, thank you, man. You know, this thing can generate heat.
Oh, thank you. Jesus, for shame. You looking for a room, mister?
Yeah.
Yeah, come on. Hey, Tamara! There's a fella here looking for a room.
Jared, it's time for dinner, baby. Can I help you?
Sign says room for rent.
It may need a little airing now.
This is just fine.
You know, since I keep kids, I have rules. No gangsters, no guns, no loud music, no women, in or out. So this may not be the type of place that you're looking for.
This seems like just the kind of place I'm looking for.
So what's your name?
Call me Bone.
Well, Mr. Bone. Any up. I'm not taking a chance on you, am I, Mr. Boone?
No.
go. You up next. It is serious. This ain't no joke.
I'm ready.
Yeah, and I want to fuck Beyonce.
Looks like you need a new fighter.
Oh, Oh, so you a fighter?
Yeah, you know what? I can sling 50 cent of nickels outside this car and hit 10 fighters. Ain't no one can fuck with him, man. What the fuck's so special about you?
Set me up a fight, and I'll show you.
Well, first of all, it's gonna cost at least 20 large to set up a fight. Second, Hammer don't fuck with no scrubs. You ain't got no name, you ain't got nothing. Who the fuck you think you are? And third, you think I'm gonna put up my own money for a fight I ain't never seen fight? Shit, you must have smoked that new kind of crack.
$260. Get me a fight with anyone.
What's in it for me?
20%. Use your own money, you get 40.
Yeah. James Franklin here. I'd like you to pay our old friend Daryl a visit.
Okay.
Either way,
nice
and sound.
Right here, James?
Yeah, a few things to take care of, you know how it is. Hard days, you coming? Hard not to. Yeah. As we can.
James, you ain't met my new fighter yet, huh? This is, what the fuck they call you anyway?
Bone.
Bone. I call him Bone because that's gonna be breaking when he hits.
In your ass, little Asian lip Russian.
Let me give you a piece of advice. You just assume glue mouse ears to your balls and dangle them in front of an angry alicat, then fuck with that girl.
What? I should never do that again.
What?
Don't pretend like you don't know.
What?
Say what one more time. Say what one more time that you don't know.
What the fuck do you mean?
James, where we going?
Daryl's. I want to go to Daryl's. Here's Shelly's cooking. Take her home.
Let's roll.
Come on, man.
Let's go.
Two cents. 6, and I got 2 assists to give me 10 to 1.
Nah, baby. 5-1. 5-1.
Huh? You killing me, D?
That's the best odds you're gonna get for a scrub.
All right, then. Let's do this. 5-1. And that's...
Hey, yo! Gather around! Gather around, everybody! We got one more matchup tonight! Gather around! Because there's a new kid in town! Y'all didn't know he was sent to serve somebody!
Break a bone, baby, break a bone.
All right, then.
Knock him off!
Here and there, you just gonna whip some ass. We're gonna stack our squids up just enough that these greedy motherfuckers around there don't know what's up. Then we go straight for James. And fuck that motherfucker. We're going straight for James, because James is the real money around here. But you gotta treat that psycho ass nigga just right, because that motherfucker kill your ass just as much as talk to you. But we gotta fuck with him just right. Take that nigga just enough so we get the odds that we want. Then we drop that motherfucker down, but fuck, you know he got Hammerman. But Hammerman ain't never put down. That's when your ass come in. You gotta whoop that motherfucker's ass.
What can you tell me about the girl?
Aw, fuck that. Hell no, no. No. Get that shit out your head right now, man. Fuck that. You need to sit right there and have a long, introspective conversation with your dick there, Holmes.
Tell me about the girl.
She's James's girl. That's all the fuck you need to know. Fuck me. Angela Soto. Right, that's her name. James is feeling it real bad. She was married, matter of fact, to a man, choir boy. I forget his name. What on the street is, James set him up. Triple homicide, sent his black ass to jail. James just swooped in, snatched the girl for himself. But the fucked up thing is, I heard she was pregnant. This motherfucker took her to a clinic and got that baby. After that, she got hooked on the horse, and that's the end of that sordid tale. Don't you ever tell me to tell you that story again, because that's the type of shit that make a brother lose all hope in humanity and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So this guy, first time up, first hole, first game, he swears. Par 5, shoots an eagle. An eagle, first try.
Wait, that reminds me, Down. You get that thing off for Franklin?
Franklin, dude, don't even worry about that guy.
We could have some music.
Yes. Good idea.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm usually shooting like a 79, 80. This guy's 72. First game.
Wow.
A little white boy music to aid digestion.
What's wrong? You don't think your brothers are down with Wang Chun?
Thank you, baby.
See, he knows it.
Make her do a high handstand.
Take your baby by the heels. Come on, sing it.
Me?
Do the next thing that you feel.
Sing with me. You don't know it, right?
We're so in phase. In our dance hall days. We're cool on craze. When I, you, and everyone we knew could believe, do, and share in what was true.
Oh, I see.
Don't take this personal. Good to you anymore. You ain't nothing but a junkie.
It's a music on new thing.
It's a new joint, man. What's his name? Cat does a song, Homegirl.
Yeah, well, turn it off. You know it don't like profanity in my home.
My bad. It's off.
What is that thing anyway?
That man is the PKL-370, better known as the Pickle. And check it, if I call you up, all you gotta do is press *40. And it automatically activates a GPS that can find you anywhere by satellite. It's tight, huh?
You know, if you ever use that thing on me, I will kill you. I'm messing with you, man.
Check this out. One kick. Fold up Big Mama like a paper bag.
Where's he from?
Only cat that knows is Panama.
okay?
Yes, my boy. Mm-hmm. My babies.
Get back. What's wrong with you?
They eat dogs in China.
Get in here. Come on, man.
Them motherfuckers.
Sorry?
Just saying. They're looking at me like Chinese takeout.
Because you don't know how to treat them.
Bling.
You want that, right? Karen, get your little behind up here right now.
Hey, you too good for nothing. Take that. Get off this block.
Man, fuck you, you gray-haired Grandpa Moses-looking motherfucker.
You Metamucil-drinking-ass motherfucker.
You don't want me to come down there, do you?
Huh?
Right. It's all in the tone of your voice. That's how you get things done around here.
Hey, yo, Bone! Time to go, partner!
It's checkmate.
What? Checkmate?
I play four moves ahead.
Yeah.
I'm not sure I approve of the company you keep, Mr. Bone.
Me neither.
Underground Fight Club shit, low key, though. You look like some scrap guy. Mm-hmm. You see that chick? It's the hit that. Pretty hot for a fighter, huh?
Okay, we got the next fight. Over here, we got this guy, Bone. He seems to think he could come here and take all our money. But tonight, he's got to put it all up against the man with the golden grill. Yeah. Now, we already seen what he does to a dude that he likes. And I don't think he likes this guy, Bone, very much, does he? I don't know. Okay. You guys ready? Fight!
shop on your punk ass spiders, man. Two at a time, bitches. Two at a time. Pay me, tattoo.
Wait. What'd you say? Two at a time?
Huh?
Is that what you said? Two. Hey, everybody heard that? Two at a time, okay? That's the bet. Two at a time.
What bet? What bet?
Hey, calm down. That's what you just said. Two at a time, right?
Hey,
Carlos.
Manuel. Hold on. Wait a minute.
Two at a time.
You scared? You gonna fool? Fuck it, man. Fuck you.
Fuck you, homie. Fuck you. Your man as good as he says he is? Let's do it.
This is bullshit.
Double or nothing.
No. Boom. He owes us money right the fuck now.
Double or nothing.
Double or nothing. Get this motherfucker, man.
So damn cheap.
keep the money.
It's all coming true. And it's all because of you, B. So what I'm trying to say is, I love you, B. No, I don't mean that in a homosexual, like I'm trying to get with you kind of way. I mean that in like a motherfucker who, you know, gotta ride a match of rims kind of way, you know what I'm saying? That's love. Damn, that was $20 and shit. Trip and fall on someone's fist? Come here. Come here. Sit down.
Are you always up this early?
Yes. Make breakfast for the children.
You take good care of those kids.
Yeah, well, I do what I have to do to stop them from being killers, thugs, hoes, street fighters. You have any family, Mr. Bone?
Long time ago.
What happened?
So how long you been taking care of the kids?
Well, Angel I've had for 3 years. Regina, about a year and a half. And Jared, about a year.
Why does Jared always stand at the window?
He's waiting for his folks to come back. As far as I know, his father's in jail. But he does have a mother out there somewhere.
Thank you.
You know, I saw you doing Tai Chi out there. I watched the old people do it in the park. It just always looks so beautiful, so relaxing.
Come here. Let me show you something. Okay. This is Tai Chi. This is called push hands. Step with your right foot. Put your hand here. Now, this hand goes on my elbow. Now, this is called push hands. When I push, you yield, roll back, and push me. Just like that. And push with your hand. And roll back. There you go.
Checkmate. 5 moves ahead, youngin.
One-sided. I'm that one-sided, old Monique. I am hurt. I am hurt. Will you stop climbing that fence? You are giving me a complex over here. You know what?
By the hammer. You know what I'm saying? You ready for this?
Yeah.
Hold steady. Just knock this motherfucker out. Afterwards, we get those little school girls. You know what I'm saying? You ready for this hammer? You ready? Let's do this! Let's do this! I don't smell no hammer! I smell pussy! Are you a pussy? No! It's a hammer, man! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
What up, James? How you doing, fam?
Got your money.
Well, there it is. Just waiting for you to give a little company. You need a county?
Bring them up.
Step to the rear! Cause the ambulance is here! Yeah!
You know that thing you always say every time I fight?
What? Oh, you mean they call him Bone because that's what he breaks when he hits? Yeah?
Don't say that.
All right, motherfuckers and motherfuckettes, it's time for the main event. Now, without further ado, let me bring to you, coming straight from Skull Island. Y'all might know him from his numerous appearances atop the Empire State Building, swatting down airplanes and shit. The primate from another climate, the Hammer of Men! From this corner, he's new on the scene, but he's stacking much green. The one technique knockout artist who's breaking down probably it just got started. The brother man with death in each hand. The man they call Bone because that's what his parents named him. Bone!
Mr. Bone, that was one hell of a show. I've never seen anything like that before in my life. You know, you cost me a lot of money.
I hear you got a lot.
No, really. You know, why don't you and Pinball come by my place? Celebrate. That way we can talk.
Oh,
I'm sorry, James, but we got some plans.
We'll be there. Good. Your invincibility lies in defense. Possibility of victory in the attack.
Glad you two could make it.
Well, I didn't think he wanted to see us out to be
wanting that money from
you tonight. Well, I guess it had to happen sooner or later. They knew you had a secret weapon. Oh, Dan was at the hospital straightening out his knee. Hey, baby, come meet my man, Bo. He just whooped the hammer, man.
Words can't describe how little I give a damn.
Fighters and the fight game. A warrior's life, that's a life for me. His honor, virtue. A warrior's life must be pure in body and spirit. That's why I don't drink, I don't smoke, I don't use profanity. Genghis Khan once said, the greatest pleasure is to vanquish your enemies and chase them before you. Rob them of their wealth and to have those dear to them bathed in tears. I am the punishment of God. And if you had not committed great sins, God would not have sent a punishment like me upon you. Genghis Khan. I am not like the rest of those thugs you see out there smoking blunts and playing video games, and neither are you. I can see that right off. Do you train with weapons? Catch. I guess you're thinking, what does this street hustler know about honor and nobility? Well, the truth of the matter is, not very much. But I am learning. I have a path, I have a vision, I have a plan that I would very much like you to be a part of.
So,
international underground street fighting is by far the biggest money-making fight game, period. It is the pastime for a group of fat cats who like to call themselves the Consortium. This is the game that I am trying to get into.
You got an in?
You ever hear of a man called Franklin McVeigh?
No.
Franklin McVeigh is an international arms dealer. Large. If there's a war in this world, that fool is probably providing the party favors. But he wasn't always this big. He's a small-time thug from London. Fellow pop guns, the little black and brown kids on the streets of America. Needless to say, that is where I met him. Anyway, Franklin McVeigh runs the international fight game for the consortium. And he manages the best fighter in the world. They call him Pretty Boy Price. Not only did he look fool you, he's already killed four men in the ring. Pound for pound, he's considered the best fighter in the world. It costs $5 million to get in the ring with him. Now, ordinarily, you'd have to work your way up the ranks to get a fight with Price. But McVeigh holds me. I want to do to Franklin McVeigh what you and Pinball did to me. You'll be Price. You can retire a very rich man. Now think about it. What is there to think about? Like I said, I'll think about it. Okay, my friend. You do that. But you should know. I don't like people to say no to me. Maybe you should get used to it. See that man? Keep looking at him. How are you?
Fuck you and them you, you both.
Hey! What well, I tell you about that language?
Fuck you. Thank you.
So why don't you go over there? Take care of my wife and my kid. That's what he told me. That's the last thing he said before he died.
Help me. You knew Danny. How?
In prison. He was my friend. Well, sorry to do this to you, but checkmate.
Hey, check this out, man. It's a beautiful picture, man. That's my family. My wife and my son. Never got a chance to meet them, but I'ma see them soon.
Somebody killed him. Thought he was me. Is this the woman that Danny cried over and begged me to look after as he was dying?
Danny.
Did you forget you had a son?
Huh? Don't you judge me. Don't you fucking judge me. The whole reason I'm in this shit is because of Danny and my son. I knew Jim set him up to get to me.
I also knew that if you couldn't have me, you would kill the Danny and my son. I always hoped he'd get tired of me and let me go. I could find my son. But that's all just a pipe dream. I don't know where my son is. I don't even know if he's alive.
Your son is alive, and I know where he is. So let's get you cleaned up and go get your son.
So that's what this whole thing is about, huh? You're my white knight here to save me from the tower.
I don't know about white knight. So I think I'm gonna like this organization. You don't look any worse for wear.
Why should I? It feels good to make love to a real man.
Hey, listen. If you're tired of it, why don't you let me take her off your hands for a while? Well, I might consider to do that. Depends upon what you're willing to do for me. What do you think? Get your stuff together. You're going with Bone for a while. And don't forget your medicine. So we'll talk about this later, right? Where you can get yourself back together.
It's anonymous, right?
Absolutely, sir.
We're good.
What about my son? I want to see my son.
Not till you're straight.
This one, miss? Thank you.
Good to see you, James. You should visit more often. I hear you've become quite the golfer.
Yes. But unfortunately, I just lost my golfing partner.
You, my friend, should learn the fine art of subtlety. So what do I owe the pleasure of this visit?
$5 million.
What's this for?
I want to fight. What's a pretty boy?
Ah, so we're looking to sit at the grown-ups table, are we?
I have a flatter. This guy's the real deal.
You're not talking about Hammerman, are you? He's not even in Price's league.
No, he's a new guy. Best I've ever seen. And I've seen Price.
Well, it's not as simple as that, James. The consortium is owned by a private organization. All newcomers have to be agreed upon by committee.
Come on, Frank. After all I've done for you, you couldn't do this one little thing.
You're asking me to vouch for you. Well, the funny thing about vouching for someone, James, is that when that someone shows himself to be less than what was promised, every decision you take from that point on is second-guessed. And that, in my line of work, is suicide. Besides, why does a cool, mellow fellow like yourself want to hang around with a bunch of stuffy old white guys?
Same reason you want to hang around those stuffy old white guys. Power. Connections. But let's keep it real. I'm just a cool, mellow fellow. Just shucking and jiving. Crip walking, basketball playing, singing, dancing, and taking out your garbage. That's what I am to you.
You're right. You are African American. And myself and my friends, for the most part, don't care for the company of African Americans. Quite frankly, we're entertained by you. We're thrilled by your high-flying acrobatics on the basketball court. That wonderful sense of rhythm you have. Your animal athleticism. But apart from that, we have no use for you. Understand? I mean, let's face it, James. Do you set a place at your dinner table for your pit bulls? Now, is this keeping it real enough for you?
I have another theory on this subject matter, and it goes something like this. I imagine 700 years ago, a group of very powerful men, not unlike yourself, were out conquering the known world. So they get to Africa, feeling pretty good about themselves, definitely feeling superior to the savages they see running in the jungle. That is, until one of the brothers drops his loincloth. And then these powerful men all of a sudden come face to face, so to speak, with one of life's great iniquities.
Well, let's whip them out, and I'll settle that myth right here and now.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, my friend. I'll stick my neck out and vouch for you. But if you let me down in front of my people, life will become very lonely for you out there on those streets. Am I clear?
Clear as well.
I'm hosting a retreat for consortium members over the next 3 days. Have your man ready in 2.
He'll be ready.
Wait.
I know this man.
You know him?
Saves a bird. Like to help kids.
The dogs on that poor sweet old man. Put the dogs on him. Shoot him up. Like a piece of meat. Understand this place anymore. I don't.
Help yourself. It'll get better. Mr.
Bone, someone's here to see you.
Come on, baby, let's go.
Cute kid. Always wanted one of my own. I gotta call you Pimp of the Year, player. I gave you my best girl 2 days ago. I turn around, and you putting it to the nanny.
What are you doing here?
It's on, brother. It is on.
What is off?
The fight between you and Bryce.
You put the money up for the fight.
$5 million.
But I never said I would fight.
Excuse me.
I told you I'd think about it. I thought about it. Decided not to fight.
Man, you and your fucking man. $5 million.
Get it back.
Get it back. Get it back. Do you know how much shit you are getting me in?
You're smarter than that.
You are in that fight. Oh, yes, motherfucker. You are in that fight. Somebody's gonna be dead.
You're right. Somebody might be.
He's the fuck back there, motherfucker.
Take this money, take the kids and check into a hotel. Stay there till you hear from me. It's too dangerous for you now.
I will. But when I come back, I want you gone.
Rustle up the crew now. On every motherfucker with a gun locked, loaded, and ready to regulate in 15 minutes. Get bone, get pinball. That bitch. The nanny. All of them motherfuckers!
With a box of collards and a bucket of chicken.
That's so good.
Where that nigga bone?
I said we're a nigga bone. What a nigga bone.
Station.
Yeah, let's talk about that later. But I'm gonna get this side of beef off of me.
Hey, homegirl says she got the 411 on Angela.
So I seen that girl y'all was talking about at the intersection.
What intersection?
No, I'm in the intersection. Back where the judge sent me to get clean. She in there. That girl, she in there.
You got that bitch yet?
Yeah, I've got her.
Bone?
Now I'm coming for you.
Mr. Bone, it's good of you to join us.
Like I said, family, you are gonna fight. And you are gonna win me back my money.
And if I don't fight,
then you die. And I'll go back to town and I'll kill the nanny. And the three little brats. And your little rat, Pinball. And this will hurt. And I'm gutting Filet Angela like a sea bass.
Just like you killed Roberto.
That stupid old man opened his mouth one time too many.
And you killed my friend Danny in prison. Set him up for a murder he didn't commit.
You knew, Danny? So that's what this is about.
Danny and Angela. He was a stupid ass boy.
He didn't deserve Angela. I guess round about now you be getting a picture about how the fuck we roll.
James, you talk too much.
Yes, you too.
I want to report a possible homicide, 4215 Westgate Terrace. Yeah, I'm about to send you a video. Alright.
So, you're ready to fight, Mr. Bone.
And if I don't,
then I'll beat you where you stand.
Need I say more? Do you want to change?
For what?
Thank you.
her by forfeit. Price.
You motherfucker.
Dane! Fuck you too.
I'll see you later.
If I go down, you go down too.
We'll see. Hey, Mom. When I get out, you got family on the outside. Believe that, big homie. Believe that.
I know I said you had to leave, but you can stay if you like.
No, you were right. You were right. I'm in trouble.
You knew that boy was here the whole time, didn't you? And who his mother was. Long before you ever came and knocked on my door.
We got some money in this envelope for you. Nobody's looking for it. I'd like Angela to stay here with Jared after she gets cleaned up. If it's all right with you.
That's all right. You did all of this just to keep a jailhouse promise.
I like to keep my promises. I gotta go.
Give you a lift?
No. I think I'll walk.
My life in the city keep going, don't it?
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure you don't want to stick around. I can set some fights up. We can make some real money, man.
Nope. Got some business to take care of.
Spin up, God!